got the cockpit all finished up now. So I did the best I could with that big old screen. I don't know, under a little gloss coat, that might look like a computer screen. I gave a nice wash to a lot of the interior surfaces. I used, there it is, Agrax Earthshade, which I thought would just give it kind of a dirtied up look. Touched up the helmets a little bit, painted the rear bulkhead, and all set to put the canopies on there. I've been rotating around between projects just so I don't have any kind of downtime. Lots of stuff to do. So in addition to working on some more of my shock troops here, I've been doing the brush painting on those in between steps on the Valkyrie. So basically ready for the paint job now. I've got everything primed with the AK White, which, by the way, I did not like. First time using that primer. I've got all my pre-shading done that I want to do. I just used some Alclad Gloss Black Primer for that on all the engraved panel lines, and then some of the other panels and raised areas throughout, just to help shade that up. And it's my favorite technique to really bring an aircraft to life. So the base color I'm going to put on this whole thing is Game Air Somber Gray, which is a very bluish gray, a very dark gray. It's similar almost to a gunship gray, but with a much darker, bluer tint to it. And I think that works really well for, you know, an aircraft that's going to serve on the battlefield. I'm all finished with my paint job, and I'm pretty happy with the way it came out. I'm a little iffy on the lighter gray. So basically, it's the somber gray for that dark bluish gray overall. The same cold gray that I use on the Lehman Russ and my armored units. And this gray might look the same right now, but this is gunship gray, and it's actually quite a bit lighter in normal light than the somber gray. And, you know, it's kind of diffused now because you have the camouflage all over it, but it's a very different dark gray. I've got engines semi-detailed, ready to go. I just did a lot of playing with layering different... Oh, look at that. That always happens, so I'm going to have to touch that up. But layering lots of different Alclad metallic colors on this to give me the kind of... exhaust, but with the, I don't know if it's showing up here, the kind of blued titanium color, and they look pretty good when it's all finished. But the ship here itself is looking pretty cool. I think I'm happy with the camouflage. I'm not sure. I'm sort of wishing I just left one color gray for the jagged edges or the somber gray instead of doing the two, but what's done is done. I think it's a good camouflage pattern. Maybe not highly effective in the real world, but looks good on the model in any case. I decided that, like I talked about with the helmets on the pilots, that kind of iridescent blue is their squadron colors. So I did the rudders and just some little panels in that blue. And I'll put some unit markings on there just to make it stand out just a little tiny bit. But I really like the Valkyrie model. It's really cool. While I was waiting for the camera battery to charge, I did a little bit of the detail painting around the thing. Just odds and ends. You know, a little bit more painting with the brush detailing on the engines there. So everything now needs a nice glossy coat, and then I can start with a good wash and some decaling and some more detail painting. Actually, it looks pretty good. I like that. And... what's frustrating me is that I have to wait till this whole thing is finished to peel up the tape and then put those canopy rails on there. I wish I could have it on there now just to see, because I'm toying with the idea of putting the blue on the canopy rails as well. But as I look at this on camera, I think I'll probably just leave it in the somber gray. Overall, this is a pretty cool-looking little ship. Once this is all done, and I'm glad that I decided to do the engines separately now, by the way, and I've used just about every brand of paint I have for the different metallic finishes on there. Alclads, Model Masters, Vallejo, MIGs, everything, just to give a really different look all around. And then the fan blades came out good, too. I like the contrast there with the blades and the rest of the intake housing. What's going to be tricky is doing a really realistic, good exhaust pattern there without messing stuff up, but... this is coming along really, really well. got quite a bit of detailing work to do on my two little crew members to fit in the back, but I've been working on them along with some more shock troops, so lots to go. I decided just to come outside and get some pictures in natural light of how this paint job's coming out, and at first that light gray, really, I thought I had kind of ruined it a little bit, but I really like it, and I realize now I forgot to put some on the front of the nose, so I think I'll just leave it alone, but I'm really happy with the look and all the colors and how this thing's starting to look. So now it's my favorite time, decaling. I have a huge spares collection that I'll put on camera also, of just decal sheets from old models and everything else, and we'll get this thing marked up and then go on to all the weathering. So I think I'm about done with selecting decals and putting them on. I used some from Games Workshop, from the kit. I used some from my spares. I'll put a shark mouth on anything, and I thought that would look really, really good. Unfortunately, the decal set that these came from, they're kind of old, and they didn't hold together as well as I would have liked, so I'm going to have to do some touch-up with the brush. I'm still deciding if I'm going to paint the continuation on the nose here. I'm probably not. I'm probably going to leave that as is. So I stole a nice little nose art pinup girl from a P-51, a P-47 kit. I put some ejection seat warnings on there because I figured, why not? That came from an old P-47. That's from World War II, P-51. And then, you know, the rest of the markings. I forgot what that came from, but just odds and ends. I have a ton of decals. So basically, every time I finish a model, I take all the unused decals and put them in here. And this is not a very good way to keep them, I understand. But I just have tons and tons of decals there. And anytime I buy aftermarket decals, and this is just, this is one of my P-51 books. Let me move this so I don't smash it. And this is just one of my World War II aircraft books. So I have just pages and pages of decals to go through. And I have them organized, you know, from era. Oh, armor, you know, aircraft, all that stuff. So I didn't want to get crazy with it. I didn't want to put a whole lot on there because as I add more Valkyries, I'm going to have to come up with some kind of continuity in the marking scheme. So I figured there were just a few markings that we could say the crew decided to put on this one versus what are standard markings, you know, across my Valkyrie world. I even went and put, I don't know if you can see it here, I got some emergency access on the crew doors there. Nothing really crazy, just enough to make it stand out and be very, very unique, you know. Alternating between Microsol and Solvacet to get these older decals, especially down around some of the more stubborn 3D features of the aircraft. Then I'm still trying to think of what I'm going to do with this door. I could just crazy glue it in place, but that's not very secure, and I have a feeling that's going to break. So I'm coming up with another solution right now to make it at least, you know, open in the position that's realistic for if it was open, not hanging down. I don't want it closed up all the time because I want to be able to see inside. So as work goes along, decals are all sitting down really nicely. I figured out how I'm going to solve the problem with that rear ramp, and it involves drilling a few holes and using some little cord. But basically, there's no mechanism in this model kit that would actually show how that door opens and closes anyway. So really simple. I found two spaces that I kind of like the positioning of, and drilled some little holes in there just big enough to fit this cord. And this cord just happens to be something I had. You know, nothing special. It's braided. I don't know if it's going to show up here. So if I paint it with like a steel color, it'll look like a steel cable. So I shaved off the bottom two rivets and then drilled some other holes right there. And then I'll just let this thing sit on its landing gears so that the door opens naturally. And then I will glue the cord in place and then cut it off and then just reinforce that. When it's all done though, regardless, if you take a look at where this cord is, positioning of that cord, once it's all snipped and secured in, the engine will hide it really, really nicely because you won't really be able to see where that hole goes. So it'll be pretty well. And then the door will still be able to open and close. It's just it won't hang down farther than, say, where it should. And there it is, all trimmed up and ready to go. And you can't even see that at all with those engines in place. And the ramp functions and comes back down. So I'll close it up for painting and everything, but it'll just hang down really nicely in flight. Well, it took a while, but all of the detail painting that I'm going to do before I do the final matte coat is done. What I just spent a long time doing is basically all of the weathering effect, the scraped paint. I think it's kind of hard to tell now, just with the light on it and everything. It'll be a lot easier to tell once it's flat coated, and the silver will stick out a lot more. But I think it's very weathered, but not in a way where it takes away from the rest of the look of the aircraft. So now what I need to do is give this thing a quick clear coat one more time, glossy, and then I can do all the wash that I want to do on it. It took a really long time to get this wash done the way I wanted to, but it's finally done. I have it all matte coated again. I used a combination of Model Master Createx acrylic black wash. I also used some Games Workshop Null Oil to do just various things around here. And I think finally now, take a look and see that the wash really added a lot to it, with a little bit of streaking, just a tiny bit, you know, here and there. All the panel lines are done though. Take it off the stand there. It really brought the engines to life a lot. A lot of the detail here is hidden underneath the wings, you know, and the doors and everything, but it came out really, really, really nice. And I think, again, the lighting where I do these videos is not the best, but tomorrow I'll get this outside in actual daylight, nice natural light, and you'll see how well this all came out. It looks really, really, really great. Super happy with the way this all came out. Now that this is done, I can unmask these little windows on the doors. I can unmask the canopy. I can put these canopy rails on there. I forgot to mention I also did the multiple rocket pods instead of the single shot larger missiles there. And nothing fancy, just did them to get them done because you really can't see a lot of detail on there anyway. I toyed, by the way, a lot with the idea of putting eyes for the kind of shark mouth, and I'm glad I ended up not doing it. And Sleepy Time Gal came out really, really nice over there. It's hard to focus. I've got all of the lenses done. It's hard to see on this video, but there's a really nice, kind of true glassy look to them. And the canopy rails are on, and everything looks good. A few little fit problems that I didn't anticipate, but I still think it looks good overall. But that's a really cool, heavy-duty look, and you can still get a really good view into the cockpits. This is what I used for all the canopy stuff. This is great clear glue for all of kind of clear parts, canopy parts, and everything. The problem is it takes a little while to dry, so initially when I put the canopies on the clear parts, you know, I rubber banded them in place, let them dry, but these rails were really easy. I just put a little bit all around and kind of let them sit right in place because the fit is so good, and they just snugged right down on there. Just a little bit that I wish I had gotten a little bit tighter seal right there, but other than that, you know, everything's pretty good. And this glue is very flexible too, so it doesn't just crack and fall off. It's really good for canopy-related stuff. The gauzy is something new to me. I found it on scalehobbyist.com, but it does really, really well for painting small little glassy areas like these lenses to give it a real glass lens look. So tomorrow, when I have this out in the daylight, hopefully you'll be able to see that a little bit better. Now we've got our crew members that need to be put in the rear, their weapons, their bolters here, and the arms and mounts that hold them in there. In the instructions, they have you do all this stuff before you assemble the interior compartment and everything, but I knew that just for the way I was going to build it, I wanted to be able to have the doors closed for all the painting, and then open them and then position our guys in later. By the way, it's really hard to tell, but those windows came out really, really well on there too. So it's going to be a little bit of a struggle to kind of get these guys in there just right. Well, that turned out to be much more of a production than I had anticipated. It was a lot harder, and I understand why they say to put the troops and the guns in before you put it all together, but I got them all assembled. So we got the left side gun, which is just sort of there. We've got our crewmen, there we go, hanging out. We've got our right side gun, which is the manned gun, and it'll look a lot better, again, in better light, but that's all done. So now, really the last step here is the exhaust for the engines and a couple other little things. And so I'm going to use a couple different techniques for that. These Tamiya weathering little compacts are great. So really all I'm going to do is just use the soot and just brush some exhaust back there, starting first with a Q-tip, and then I'm going to use kind of a stiff brush to space it out and spread it out a little bit. And this stuff is pretty easy to use. All you got to do is really just brush it on there. You can see it's starting to build up the exhaust layers there, but it's already looking pretty effective. Another technique that I like to use that turns out pretty well is take just chalk pastels and grind them up against some sandpaper, and then take a brush. I like this one. It's a little bit stiff, but not too stiff. And you just take them off the sandpaper and brush them on, and it works pretty well because when you grind it up, you get some very fine powder. I'm not going to use black. I'm going to use a very dark brown just to give a little bit of a contrast to the Tamiya soot. And the exhaust effect is done. We got the insides of the booms there. And just the slightest little bit on the undersurface there. So this is a completed aircraft. So this might get a little bit shaky because I'm doing this handheld, but I just really wanted to get some shots of this out in natural light. And it came out better than I really had hoped. So let's take a little tour here of this Valkyrie. And I'm going to leave it on the stand now, but I'll move it around to capture some of the detail stuff later on. Very happy with the engine detail. I think all the colors came out great. The weathering, that engine exhaust came out great. Crew members in the back compartment really look good. The lenses all looked awesome. I'm really glad I didn't put the eyes on the shark mouth there. I think it really adds to not have it there. I know it's a little shadowy here, but our crew members look really good in their positions in the back. Let's see if we can get a little bit more light. There we go. With all the detailing that was done inside. It was such a pain to get those guys in there, to get those guns mounted. So that's something I'll do differently next time for sure. Get a better view of the nose art we have on there. Because it's got that semi-gloss look, it's a little hard to see, but all those targeting lenses came out great with the gauzy as a top coat. Pilots look awesome in their cockpits. It was totally worth all the time detailing the inside to have that visible. And I don't know if it's showing up on camera, but you can see the gauges inside the instrument panel and the work on that big computer screen to make it look a little more lifelike. So just imagine, I don't know, you're Acadian, you're on the battlefield, waiting for some support or to be picked up and taken home, and here comes Sleepy Time Gal to come take you home. Yeah. What a great kit in general. What a lot of fun to build. Seriously, just a lot of fun to build. But seriously, thanks for joining me, you know, as I work on this. Thanks for watching these videos, and I hope you'll stick around and watch some more.